The standard location for a script is in the Script TGML object. By setting the Use Global Scripts property, we can reuse scripts across the page. Let's look at one final location to store JavaScript files to be used on all pages. First, we need to enable script deployment. In the Web HMI, under the Settings tab, Diagram, Viewer, there is the option Enable Custom Script. I'll select this, save, and reload the page. Now I have a new entry in the library, Custom Script, which is where we can manage the scripts. There are two ways to upload JavaScript into the system. If I already have an external file, maybe that's been copied from another server, I can click Select JavaScript, which is where my custom scripts are located, and Upload JavaScript. Since I don't have a separate file at the moment, instead, I'll just move the text from the global script into this window. Before I can use the script, I need to validate that it is good JavaScript, then save it to the server. Finally, to use the script, I must deploy it. This makes the objects globally available to all pages. This has the major advantage in terms of loading time because these objects only need to be loaded into the browser once per session. When a new page is opened, these are just loaded from the browser's cache rather than the server. Back in Graphics Editor, I can delete that top-level script object. The script will now be loaded into the global context by default by the system data service. If I save the page now, and return to the Web HMI, my object still changes color correctly. However, that brings us to the downside of loading scripts this way. Because the scripts are loaded by the web server, they are not available in the preview mode. Previewing the page will throw an error that the JavaScript function can't be found. There are two solutions to this. The first and simplest is what we just did. Develop all your JavaScript inside the TGML file first, then copy out to deploy.js afterwards. This isn't sustainable over a project's life, though. You will eventually need to return to the page, modify or create new JavaScript, and test it. It's not reasonable to copy all the code back and forth every time a change is made. You can also undeploy the file in Settings, make changes in the editor, then redeploy to test. But this process is rather lengthy for small changes. The last option is to debug your code directly in the browser. However, this takes a bit more setup, so I'm going to save that for another video. Until then, thank you.